This is my WW, and I was talking to the guy. He subscribed to my videos, and I'm gonna tell him what he can improve on the deck. Okay, well, as you can see, the lacquer is kind of screwed up. It's kind of like, it looks like a plastic wrap over it. I think you guys can see that. That's not very good, but the screw holes are drilled pretty good. Pretty good. The lacquer's better on the top, actually. I don't even know if there is. Yeah, there is. Just, it's better on the top, believe it or not. And the deck is kind of twisted, if you can see. Hold it straight. See, I'm holding it straight and how it's twisted? A little bit there. Or not there. There. There we go. Right there. I think that this is because of the way his mold is, and it's a 4-ply deck. So I think if he just made it 5-plies, it'd be better. And yeah, other than that, it's a pretty good deck. It's a lot better than my Flick deck. It's good size. It's about the tiny bit smaller than my Berlin Wood. A little bit higher kicks. Oh, one other thing is the concave. There's like none, just barely any. So a little bit of more concave would be nice, but all in all, I think if he improved on those things that I just said, he'd have a pretty good deck. So yeah, thank you to, I think it's Wyatt something, for sending me this, WW Fingerboards. But don't buy one just yet, just wait till he fixes those few things. And this will be a good deck to buy. Oh, and the kingpin holes are pretty good. So, yeah. Hey, guys. Yeah, the last part that you just watched was from a while ago. And I never posted this review. But, I'm going to finish it. And, yeah, I'm a little intoxicated at the moment. But, whatever. So, here's my WW fingerboard. As you can see, the nose or one of the tails or whatever you want to say it snapped off. Not because my friend Reese was actually using this board. I gave it to him. He wasn't stomping on it or anything or slamming it down. He was in class one day, just shredding. It was for a simple kickflip. Snaps the tail right off. That's really, really bad, and it's a really weak deck here. Look, you can probably see me bend it. That's barely any pressure. I know I was being nice in the first part of this video, but honest to God, guys, don't buy this. It's not a good deck at all. The lacquer is really shitty. You saw that in the first vid. It's warped as fuck. You can see a bit. There's no concave. Just don't buy one. They're really bad. And yeah, just stick to companies that are actually known, like Homewood, Holywood, Flatface, Black River, Preet. Yeah, those are some good companies to buy stuff from. They're good. Don't buy a WW fingerboard. They're really shitty, just like my Flick. They're better than the Flick. The Flick are better made, they're just shittier. This was actually like a decent deck to use, but it was really soft. I know that doesn't really help anything, because you can't describe it really, but this is just really soft wood and you can bend it easy. Here, look. Here, watch this. Okay, you watching? Can you see how much that's bending? There you go. It's broken again. Shitty made. It was hard to break this. I couldn't break that really, but I just snapped that easy. Not even worth it at all. Look at that. Look at this. I can't break that. And I know I'm not even strong, so if it took no effort to break this, then that's just bad. So don't buy a WWE fingerboard, they're really shitty. Yeah. Thanks for watching my review, and pretty much don't listen to anything I said in the first video, or in the first part of this video. So yeah, don't buy a WWE fingerboard, they're really shitty. Thanks.